Halloween. I wanted to do a video and share with you some of my favorite Halloween memories. Now, at the end of this video, I'm going to show you what I'm thinking about wearing this year. It's very, very scary. Let me warn you up front. But let me start with when I was a kid. The very first Halloween costume that I remember wearing, and I only have the vaguest memories of this, was one of the few store-bought costumes I ever had. Now, at the time, there were just four of us siblings, so my little brother was either not born yet or was too young to go trick-or-treating, but understand that there's a six-year age difference between the two of us, so he may not have even been born yet. Anyway, when you've got four kids and it's the, you know, mid-60s, what perfect costume but the Beatles? Yes. We had the store-bought costumes of John, Paul, George, and Ringo. And I can only guess that I was probably Ringo, since I would have been, you know, I was the youngest and ergo the smallest. But I really don't remember who was who. My sister was probably Paul, I'm sure. She was the eldest and she would have, I'm sure, wanted to be Paul. Anyway, that's the very first Halloween I remember. But for the most part, we always wore homemade costumes. You know, when you have a family as big as ours, it just gets too expensive to buy store-bought costumes all the time. So, you know, we went as a hobo or cowboy, princess. I was a gypsy one or two times. Of course, the ever-popular ghost, your generic undead or vampire, you know, that kind of thing. But we always made our own costumes, or my mom, of course, helped us make costumes, and as we got older, we would just do each other's. I mean, between the oldest and the youngest, there's a 13-year age difference, so the elder kids would help the younger kids come up with costumes. But the best part when we were kids was, of course, the actual candy haul at the end of the night. Now, these days, I see kids using the little pumpkins. My daughter used, you know, the little plastic pumpkin to go trick-or-treating. Not when we were kids. We used pillowcases, all the more room for all that candy. And when we got in at the end of the night, that puppy was easily half full. Now, then came even the better part. It was cool to go trick-or-treating and get all this candy, but you know, you always end up getting candy that you don't necessarily like. So what we would do, the four of us, and then later on when my little brother was around and he would join in, we would dump our candy out onto the living room floor and then start trading. You know, for instance, there's a candy called a Mary Jane that I hated, but my brother number two loved. So I'd say, okay, I'll give you three Mary Janes for one Reese cup. And also I should point out, in those days, we didn't have these fun-size candy bars. No, we had the real thing, you know, full-size, the big pack of Reese cups that had two in there and things like that. None of these little mini things. So it was a lot of fun. We ate tons and tons of candy, of course. Now, I have a picture of one of the costumes I made for my younger brother. You know, naturally, since there's such a big age difference, I quickly was no longer trick-or-treating, but he still was. And one year, he decided he wanted to be Dracula, so I helped him with his costume. He just wore a pair of black slacks and a white shirt, that was easy. And then I made him this cape, this black cape with a red lining that had the big stand-up collar. And the hard part was his hair. You see, my younger brother is blonde. And I mean, back in those days, he was blonde blonde. You can't have a blonde Dracula, it doesn't work. And we didn't have anything to dye his hair, nor would he have wanted to dye his hair. So what I ended up doing was getting a couple of charcoal briquettes, you know, the things you'd put in a grill, crushing them up and adding a little bit of water to make a paste, basically. And then I combed it all through his hair. So he was really more like a gray Dracula. But anyway, here's a photo. Check it out. There he is. Yeah, he really is a blonde, you just can't tell it. Anyway, the cape turned out kind of cool, I think. I apologize for the quality of the photo. That was taken in 1977. It's a really old photograph. Now, as I got into adulthood, and for some of you, you know this, I was actually married once before Neverblatz. And my first husband and I belonged to this medieval reenactment group. So I had made, over that time period, a slew of period-style costumes for the both of us, but I had quite a wardrobe of these. So for many years, when I went to Halloween parties as an adult, I would wear one of those costumes. And I eventually made several of those similar costumes for my daughter. So she and I went A few times, you know, as a matched set. For instance, this is a picture of her and I from 1990. I actually have a second picture composited in so you can see a better picture of what she was wearing. There we are. Man, I don't look like that anymore, do I? Yes, I wasn't always as fat. I was a little bit skinnier in that picture. Anyway, Nofer Blatz and I often would dress up as a coordinating pair, for instance. Our daughters, one school she went to, would do this fall festival every year, and we would go dressed up in costume and help out at the festival. They had rides and games and things like that. But we were punk rockers one year, kind of goth looking punk rockers. We were spies one year, but there was one particular year where we didn't coordinate our costumes. I think that year I was a mechanic and our daughter dressed up as an old man, but Nofer Blatz dressed up as Roadkill. this would have been from 1993. Check it out. He had the shirt and the pants out in the driveway and he drove over them. But the tire tread marks didn't show up very well, so he went back over them with magic marker. Doesn't he look cute? Man, look at that hair. He actually had some back then. Anyway, I made my daughter a lot of different costumes over the years. I didn't buy her store-bought costumes since, you know, for the most part, I never wore store-bought costumes. I wanted to show you a few of the costumes from when she was real little. Here's a picture of her very first Halloween. She was 2 and a half. So this would have been 1984 when she wore this one. There's my little princess getting ready to go trick-or-treating. How about those tennis shoes, huh? They don't quite go with the rest of the costume. Anyway, the next year, she wanted to be the same thing every little girl in that time period wanted to be, Madonna. Oh, I made the skirt and the little lace top and the little lace glove on her hand, but the best part of this costume was the fishnet stockings. They were actually a pair of knee highs that I found, but they were perfect for her. They went all the way up. Wasn't she cute in that one? That's actually one of my absolute favorite pictures of her. Anyway, now as I promised at the beginning of this video, I wanted to show you what I think I was going to be my Halloween costume for this year. Now, I decided I wanted to wear something extremely scary. I'm usually not a real scary, you know, I usually don't wear something real scary. But this year, I decided let's go all out. Now, if you are faint of heart, if you don't think you can handle it, you should probably turn off the video now. Are you ready? Here we go. Happy Halloween.
See ya.